guys, welcome back to Shiny Bright Doggo. My name is Laura, and if you are new to Shiny Bright Doggo, Janine and I are vintage holiday treasure hunters mainly, but we look for vintage pieces, kitschy mid-century goodness. We are all about it. And today, well, here's the thing. The events that are about to unfold happened on Monday. It is Friday today. I saw this really amazing looking estate sale. As you guys can see, it looks like a lot of older stuff, a lot of toys, some comics maybe. And as you can see, there's also some good Christmas stuff. The sale was supposed to start on Wednesday at noon, which is very untypical for a sale. Typically, estate sales start on a Friday or Saturday, the weekend, which makes sense. So I was pretty confused, and the address was supposed to release for 9 a.m. the morning before. So I was just a little curious what this estate sale company typically does. So I decided to give them a ring and find out more information because I was very interested in the sale. As you guys can see in this picture in particular, there are some older vintage Christmas pieces that are pretty collectible, things that we don't have in our collection. So I was very interested. So I decided to give them a ring and something happened. You guys are gonna wanna stick around. I will say most of this video is us going through a massive, massive haul that we got. It is one of the most amazing hauls that we've ever gotten. I know we say that a lot, I know, but we've had really good luck lately. And today was no exception, or rather Monday, but today's Friday, but you know what I mean. Anyway, we're gonna head in. We hope you guys enjoy seeing some of the amazing vintage treasures that we found. So the thing is, I called to find out more information about tomorrow because the times were stressing me out. And she says, I'm having people over today. And I'm like, oh, okay. She's like, are you local? I'm like, yeah. She's like, we're starting at 2, you can come over. I'm like, okay. Thank God I'm working from home today. So I dragged Janine. I don't think she's gonna come into the home because of her allergies and asthma, which I have too, but. And I guess we're gonna see what we get and how it is and if there are other people. I have no idea. I've never done or had something like this happen to us before for an estate sale. Just gotta roll with the punches, right? So let's go and see what happens. Before we do go in, guys, I did want to make a note that this footage is going to be shaky. It's going to be me sort of spinning around in places at times, and that's just because it was extremely difficult to film in here. It was very overwhelming, but I do find it important, and I think it's important to try to capture some of that for you guys to really give you the experience of what it was like. But I do know some people get a little motion sickness, which I do too sometimes when watching videos. So if you want to skip, I'll put in a timestamp on the screen and you can skip ahead to the haul. Okay guys, so we are in the home and I immediately run to the tray that I saw in the pictures, and it's pretty overwhelming. There is a lot more stuff than I was expecting, like this Santa doll. I had no idea he was there. There are blow molds and Santa heads everywhere. So I'm actually just thinking right now, like, how am I gonna shop this sale with the amount of stuff there is? I do manage to get the tray downstairs, and in the kitchen, I stop by the salt and pepper shaker cabinet and I add them to my pile that I have started in the kitchen, which is already pretty big, but you guys will see later in the video, there's just so much stuff here. We got a ton. And most of the house was pretty much the same, just boxes and boxes filled with items, like as if it was almost an antique mall. It was quite amazing. I took a look at this little shelf, but did not grab anything from it. When I spun around, this is a pretty good representation of what most of the house looked like. Just stuff everywhere in boxes. The upstairs room had most of the Christmas stuff. I went back to where I was originally just to scope out the area, but saw mostly glass. It was another room that there was a ton of Christmas, just boxes and boxes of it. Wrapped putz houses, Santas, here's a blow mold that I found. It was all just hidden. It was incredible. It was almost like a private pick. There were a couple of other people with us while I was looking, but really it was quite incredible. There were just Rosbros and all different types of Christmas all over the house. In this little corner, I did find some Halloween masks. Now, we didn't find too much Halloween. Most of what was here throughout the entire house was really Christmas, comics, and toys. Not a ton of Halloween, but I did pick these up. because, I mean, we love and always are on the search for vintage Halloween. It's really hard to find. So right now I'm carrying, I don't know how I carried that box with the tree stand in it, but I'm trying to carry it into the next room where then I found even more Christmas. And eventually I had to call Janine in to help. And on my way out, I also spotted this brooch, which in hindsight must have fell out of my box. I did not, we don't have that in the haul. I don't know where it went. That's just how much stuff there was, how big my piles were. I guess that one just escaped the pile. So this was the main room. As you can see, boxes are everywhere. I didn't even know where to begin, guys. It was really overwhelming. There were a lot of items too that were broken. So while I'm trying to look through everything and decide what to take, I'm also trying not to take things that are broken, just to save some time and energy. But it was incredible what was in this room, the amount of boxes, the amount of toys. It was truly as if it was the back stock room of an antique mall. And I know this footage doesn't really give too much context into what we actually found in the room, but I think it does give a pretty good example of what things looked like, how things were found, the things that we did find, literally just in boxes. We are about to head into the hall, but I think like one thing we learned from the sale is to call ahead, get more information about the sale. You never know what opportunities may be there for you if you just reach out and find out a little bit more. It's definitely something I'm going to continue to do in the future because this just goes to show you never know.
Yeah, I'm trying to see what you got here.
I got a lot.
Is this?
Yeah.
This pile?
Look at this. Is that fun?
That's so cool. Yeah.
This is in your box.
I know.
That's
amazing.
It's never been used.
There's like five of them up there.
Right.
Oh, yeah, but look at these like little elves, like for Christmas, yeah. You know?
Oh my god. Just the artwork alone.
Exactly.
Did you see all those comic books?
I didn't even look. It's amazing though.
Mm-hmm.
I dragged Janine in. We got the loot. This is absolutely incredible.
I washed my hands.
Okay, good.
Should I wash?
I have gloves. Maybe I should wash
them. Oh, you had gloves. Right.
Yeah.
There. Okay.
Let me just move pumpkin.
Yep.
And the tree topper, which is from a different sale.
Yeah.
This is unbelievable. We got, I think, a really good deal though.
Yeah.
So we're happy. Okay. Close her up.
Close her up.
Okay guys, the last thing you saw in the footage, which I know there wasn't a lot of, but you'll have to believe me when I do say that it was just boxes and boxes of any and everything you could imagine, really from like the 50s through the 60s, maybe early 70s. It was unbelievable. But in our last clip, we were negotiating a price for our entire pile, which was a massive pile, guys. We're gonna get into that haul now. We spent a total of $500, which is a lot of money, but I think for what we got, it was a steal and a half, especially since we were able to go into the home early.
Yeah,
it was almost a private pick. There were a few other people, but like, I got
everyone was nice.
Everyone was
like,
so nice.
Yeah, looking out for each other. So it was really cool.
Yeah, everybody was super nice, and we got there pretty early, so we did get a lot of stuff. So we're gonna show you guys that now.
Is this the biggest haul we've ever had?
I think so.
Yeah, definitely.
We've had it like fill up the trunk, but not like really fill up the trunk like this.
Like once we start getting in, there's like so many little things. Like there's just so much stuff. So let's kind of figure out how we're gonna do this.
Yeah,
and
we're gonna show you guys everything, and we'll talk about some of the pieces. Janine doesn't know what's in here.
No.
Because I had to call her midway. I had this big pile around me, and I just couldn't carry it down the stairs. I was like, Janine, I'm gonna need your help. Sorry to call you in. And she came to my rescue and helped me carry things down. But like, I literally just grabbed boxes because they look so full of good stuff. So it's gonna be a surprise for me and Janine and you guys. So this was one of the first things I saw in the home. I actually went in, turned on my GoPro, and realized the battery was dead. I was not expecting this volume of stuff. You guys saw the pictures and it looked like some good stuff, but literally had no idea the amount of stuff. So this was one of the things I saw that was not in the pictures. This is a vacuum formed jack-o'-lantern with a cardboard back.
Wow, it's a flat back.
Yeah, you put in a little light in there, right, Janine? Mm. And this is from probably the 60s or the 70s.
That's so cool. I've never seen one of those.
It's in really good condition, too.
Two classic Empire Santa Blow molds from 1968.
Oh, that's when the mold is made, so it could be newer.
This one's probably a little bit newer. This one's probably a bit older. It is broken on the back, but I thought we could definitely rehome him and somebody would still like to display with him.
Oh, yeah.
You don't even know.
Yeah, I mean, displaying... You can't even see the little hole, so...
It's a pretty big hole.
Well, yeah. But from the front, he displays fine. And I just love seeing two little Santas together.
Classic blow mold, which we love. And we have even more in there. Some that we haven't even, like, don't even have in our collection, which is so exciting.
So, Laura, this was something that we did see in the photos.
We did. Right? I half saw it. I couldn't believe when I did see it how cute it is. This is an old Christmas tree stand given...
Super dirty.
Everything was very dirty. And I talked to the woman who was running the sale, and she said this woman was a collector and reseller on eBay. So she had a massive hoard of things, I guess she planned to sell on eBay, but never did. And it was just incredible. So yeah, everything was pretty dirty, a lot of broken things. But this is an older tree stand. Mm-hmm. Looking at the cord, it's probably from the 60s. How cute is it?
And I'm wondering if we can get a date on the paper in there.
Ooh.
Trying to find a date on the paper just to see when that was put in there.
1997.
So maybe she had bought that in 97. It's been sitting there.
There might have been stuff. Who knows how long it was sitting there, but pretty cool.
And that's what? Probably from the 50s?
50s, 60s maybe?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We've never found a tree stand before.
No, it's really exciting. They're pretty collectible. Some of the ones that are really... intricate in its graphics sell for a lot of money. This one looks like it's almost like decaled on, mm-hmm. so it probably wouldn't sell for as much, but it's still really cute.
It's so cool.
And we might have to use it.
Guys, we haven't even like dived in here yet. Okay, so I'm just gonna start pulling things out. This magic foil pure aluminum wrap I thought was so cool. There was like six of them in the upstairs room. I fell in love with these little elves.
Oh, so cute.
And I picked up two of the boxes. I picked up this bag not really knowing what was in it. I took a sneak peek and I was like, okay, I just gotta grab all of it. This is a metallic little bag. It probably said Merry Christmas in foil right there. I do have one of these, but not this one in particular. And then I haven't even looked in here. Have you seen this, Janine?
No, okay. I haven't. Obviously, I haven't.
This is like a Rosbro Santa, right. And he does have his tree in here somewhere, I believe. Yes, he does. Here it is.
Now, he would light up. He has... a little hole in the back where the light would go. He's a hard plastic, not a blow mold, and he's like from the 60s, no?
50s, 60s. Pretty collectible, sought after. I mean, definitely scuffed up, but amazing. And then look, there's more friends in here.
Oh, wow.
A flocked Santa.
Now that's actually in pretty good shape.
Yeah, some of these things are in good shape. I guess being kept in the bag. Look at that guy. He's mm-hmm. a cute one too, and he's made in Japan. So anything, oopsie, just fell out. Anything made in Japan, which most of this, probably like 90% of this was, means that it was made probably anywhere from the early 50s to mid, almost late 60s.
Yep.
And it makes it amazing vintage Christmas goodness. What else in here? Oh, look, it's a Rosbro.
Oh, wow. And it's not broken.
It's not broken. How amazing is that?
Wow. This is marked right here.
Yep, there it is.
It's marked.
Pretty collectible, like a $20 little piece right there. Some more plastic guys. This is probably newer, from the 80s. Look at this little guy.
Oh wow.
Super 70s. So that was just in this bag that I just grabbed. But this I saw in the pictures. And I was so excited. This is a hard plastic, almost like that Santa you guys just saw, blow mold, holding his original shovel. I don't even know the maker on this. I've never really seen this before. This is like a really rare find.
Yeah, this is incredible. This is extremely dirty, but you can tell that I'm so excited. I'm like, you can tell that we will be able to clean it up, which is so exciting. His little broom goes like that. Actually,
I mean, he's so great. Something like this we would wipe clean with like some Dawn and a wet paper towel and then go mm-hmm. in with a magic eraser. A great find for the collection.
Look at that plug, definitely old.
I wonder if it works. We haven't tested. So that was incredible, right? And then, oh, this was actually the one in the picture with the flat back with this little hand waving up like that.
And that is so cool because they are basically the same, but this one is a flat back.
Yep. He probably, I guess he lost his shovel over time, but how cool is that? I'll have to do a little bit of research, put in a comp here if we can find them.
Here he is. This is the non-flatback version. He sold for over $100 recently in October. So a great find indeed.
And I mean, you could put anything in there. You could make a candy cane. You can put a little flag that says Merry Christmas. Mm-hmm. Like things like that. I don't know about other collectors, but stuff like that doesn't really bother me because you can customize it a little bit and it's really cool.
We had to move inside because it was getting really windy out. We wanted to make sure you guys could hear us. Hopefully the lighting is good for you guys, but we're gonna go through the rest. We barely made a dent in it. And I also wiped down the jack-o'-lantern. I mean, it looks completely different.
Wow, so clean.
So with this box, I literally just grabbed it, guys. I saw some Rosbros and some plastic guys sticking out of it, and I just grabbed all of it. This one luckily is unbroken. This is from the 1950s or 60s. It is a candy container, very collectible. There are a lot of things that were broken, but hopefully if we take a look in here, most things won't be, but I really don't know going into it. Here are two Rosbro Angels. That one has a little broken halo right there. Janine corrected me. These are actually Bradford Angels. Bradford made plastic ornaments during the 60s. Looks like we might have a Noel set. Oh my gosh.
I have her.
Here's the N.
I don't have the N though.
Here's the O, who's in rough shape. And maybe we can get her crazing a little less yellow. So there's the O. Which letter do you need, Janine?
I need two. Actually, I have two, but one is broken.
Here's the E. Do you have an L?
I think that one might be broken.
Because this one's broken as well.
But you know, we could like put a little bit of
polymer clay.
Yeah, clay. And
but I mean, a whole ceramic set just in this box.
Wow.
Got some plastic reindeer.
Wow,
look at these. They have their legs, which typically so cool. Break off. These might have originally belonged to a sled set with Santa. Look at all these yellow birds.
Interesting. Are they marked?
Look how many there are.
Oh my goodness.
It's like a dozen of them. I'm gonna take a closer look. No markings. Oh wait, look.
Oh.
So we can fix her.
We use a little bit of epoxy to fix ceramics.
It works very well. No markings on the birds, but I think these might be 50s. They seem like a thinner plastic. There's a bunch of them in here. I'll have to do some research. I don't know who she is. She's a little doll. And look at this, just hanging out in here.
Wow.
Double glow tree ornament hangers, made in USA. These are from the 60s or 50s. Cardboard box. A little chalkware priest guy. Block Santa boy. Another double glow ornament box hanging out in there. So this, just this box had a bunch of stuff.
So cool.
I found this Santa, plastic Santa sled with reindeers in its original packaging. This is so cool.
Amazing.
Never really find them in the packaging. This is made in Hong Kong, which dates it to probably the early 70s. And it has the original price tag of 77 cents on it.
Wow.
This is so cool to find.
You guys may have saw in the beginning of the video, the footage I did manage to capture, I grabbed a bunch of Halloween masks. And those were really cool. They weren't very Halloween-esque. They weren't like monsters or witches. And I was having a really hard time holding on to everything around me. So I had to make a difficult decision. This is before I called Janina to help me, and I dropped those masks in favor of this one.
I think you did a great job, a wise choice.
Thank you. I grabbed the mask and I believe the outfit's in there. This is the first time we found like a 1970s costume in the box like this in the wild and not like at an antique mall.
Mm-hmm.
So it has the mask in there. It's got its full package. Look how cool that is. Made in the USA.
Wow.
Do you want to open it up and see if the outfit's in there?
Here is the little cape.
That's so cute.
With the witch face and the cat.
Little skirt.
How incredible. It's all in there. And the mask is in really good condition.
I love that. That's awesome. Oh boy, Laura.
Oh boy. So this was the tray I saw in the pictures that drew me to the sale. And I just grabbed the whole thing, quite honestly. This is the first time for us finding a little Humpty Dumpty Santa doll.
I love him so much. I've been wanting one.
Grabbed him right away. He's a little dirty, but I mean, can't complain. Look at that little face. He's got a little plastic, very thin face, very brittle. So I'll have to clean him off carefully. But I mean, he's in pretty, you know, displayable to condition.
Mm-hmm.
He's so cute. He might have a piece missing to him. A
little button or something.
Something like that.
But we can repair it.
And guys, when I saw this tray, I saw some Holt Howards. And I got very excited. Holt Howard is, you know, everybody knows him, right? He is, or it is a company from the 1950s and 60s who made kitschy ceramic pieces.
With a solid mass of
something. Salt in there.
Salt, yeah.
These are the infamous Santa salt and pepper shakers. They're in okay condition.
Holt Howard sticker on there.
Yep. And what I was really excited about, I don't know if he's in here, but the nutmeg was here too. I think I might have moved him to a different box. We'll find him later. There is a Holt Howard mug in here, Janine.
I just saw that.
Can you believe that?
Wow. A Holt Howard winking Santa mug.
And he belonged to a set. I'll put a picture
in. He is real dirty.
Right here. This is the set he originally belonged to. 1959. The cutest little Santa mug.
Does say Holt Howard down there too.
Wow. So that's exciting. And yeah, there's a whole picture set. Wow, look at that. Ooh. There is a marking on the bottom, so this may be like a Napco or a Lufkin some sort.
Mm-hmm.
Look at that. More Santa mugs. This belonged to the set right here, probably.
Oh, look, it's a Fun World, like a pullback Santa, and he would, you know.
Oh, cool.
Very cool.
I think they made him in bigger versions, too. I've never seen someone so small.
Sorry. He's made in Hong Kong, so he's probably from the 70s.
Mm-hmm.
Possibly 80s, even, but most likely 70s.
He's cute. And then, you know, there's some little paper face.
Stop. I didn't know that you found one of these little cuties.
I mean, I didn't quite find him. He was just sort of hanging out in that tray, but yeah.
He has a sticker on the bottom, made in Japan, him as well. Yeah. So he's definitely probably from the 50s. What do you think?
Yeah.
Put him over here.
I'm putting him right there. I just noticed. There's another one.
He's a little bit different. Oh, I didn't even notice. There's much stuff in here.
He's a little bit different.
Oh, look. He has a sticker on him. Made in Occupy Japan. Janine, do you know what that means?
That's, he's older than what?
So Occupy Japan means that it was made during the time in which the U.S. occupied Japan after the Second World War. So that is late 40s, early
wow.
50s. Yeah.
He's so cool. He is so cool. I'm so happy that he was in that tray. Like, these are so, like, old and you just don't find them often, like, ever at estate sales. Usually in antique malls we see them.
Yes. So, okay, what else do we have here? I picked this up in a different room. This is a Napco, I believe, Umbrella Girl. She used to have a little ceramic umbrella in that tube right there, but I thought she was too cute to not pick up.
Could you talk about those little fishies?
Yeah, so there was a salt and pepper shaker cabinet. I grabbed these Santas out of there. I don't think they have any markings on them, but, you know, they're from the 60s. They're meant to look like little Santa mugs, sort of.
Mm-hmm.
But yes, these anthropomorphic fish are amazing. I think they were the first set I picked up out of that cabinet. They have little cork stoppers on the bottom.
Mark Japan.
They've got the cutest little anthropomorphic faces. Almost reminds me of a Disney, like an early Disney cartoon.
Wow, you can really see that they almost have like a pearl color to them, like pearlescent.
These are really popular and collectible. Depending on the buyer, could probably resell for $40 to $50. Easy to see why, because they are just so cute.
And can we see the sides?
Yeah, look how pretty the colors are.
Wow, they are really pretty. Very pretty.
Got a little Humpty Dumpty plastic rattle type ornament, probably from the 70s. What else? We have Flocked Santa in here, although I don't know if he was the one that we just pulled out of that bag. Nope, I don't think so. He's got a little elf face. Look how cute he is.
Oh, wow.
With the little ears.
Different.
Yeah, that face is definitely different. Harder to find, real cute. So that's most of what is in this
box. I mean, it just keeps growing and growing. Oh, what is that? Wait. MG Incorporated, 1960.
You didn't talk about him.
Oh, I know, but he's missing his feet. It's in another box, so we gotta wait for that guy. He's maybe the most exciting find out of this box.
Who? Him. Oh, yes.
But wait. Can you hold the camera or him?
Yeah.
Sorry, because I think he has a top, which I'm guessing is maybe this.
Oh! So cream and sugar. Yes!
Cream in here, right? And sugar in there. But usually they come with a spoon. I guess this one didn't really come with a spoon.
That is so unique.
Different. Look at his ears. He's like a true Santa elf.
Yeah.
Okay, last thing out of this tray that was just hidden in one of the Santa mugs is this adorable little angel. Janine, if you could hold the camera so that I could sort of fan out her dress, which is made out of this like nylon pantyhose material.
Oh, I love things like that.
And what's special about her is that she has a little porcelain face. This is made out of ceramic.
I would say a lot of things special about her, especially that little wand.
Oh, she's so cute. So here's her little dress. Oh my goodness, look how much better she's looking.
Oh, she is amazing.
How cute is she? I love these. These are hard to find in good condition.
Mm-hmm.
Look at the little mercury bead hands. Okay, we'll stop talking about her because we have a lot more to go through. Okay, guys, so here's the next pile. It's this entire IKEA bag filled with stuff.
I have requested to look in here because this is killing me. I want to see all these little goodies because this girl is peeking out at me. And then this guy's peeking out. Oh my goodness, who is that?
Oh my gosh, what is that?
Oh, Thomas Edison.
No.
Right? Isn't that a kite?
You think so?
I have no idea. Isn't that a kite?
Japan? Yeah, it's a kite for sure. I mean, he's dressed like... I mean...
Are we dumb?
He's either Thomas Edison or he's a snowman flying a kite dressed in old garb. I think he might be right because Thomas Edison flew the kite for electricity.
Yeah.
Something like that. What else do we have in here? So Janine pulled out the majority of the picks and little plastic doodads that were in here. I didn't realize how many were Halloween.
Amazing amount.
Wow.
Like, so many.
Look at the witch and the cat. These are probably from the 70s, made in Hong Kong, very collectible. Look at these little bunnies. Look at this little snowman. How cute. So yeah, this I just saw the box. I lifted it up. I was like, let's just grab the whole thing. And it's filled with great things.
Gotta talk about that cat, Laura.
Okay, yeah, this cat I threw in the bag thinking it was something from the 80s. It is not. I thought it was from like the 80s or 90s. Like, oh, this is cute. This is whatever. I'll just take it. This is like a 1970s
fun world.
It actually says it on the... It says made in Hong Kong, I think. Right there. It is a Fun World little wheelie rolly
toy.
Cute,
the way it works.
It is so cute. Look at that cat face. And then he just rolls and the little jack-o'-lantern rolls with him. And this thing, unbeknownst to me, is worth like $40. There's a witch version too. It's worth over $100. So maybe that's still at the home and we should go back on Saturday. Janine, I think we're getting into some of the items that you haven't seen at all. That I put in a bag before you even... came into the room. I found two Rosbros that are really dirty, but they're in pretty good condition otherwise. These guys, I think they were just in one of the bags or boxes I grabbed. I didn't realize they were broken. But look at these Santa dolls.
Amazing.
Got this guy from like the 50s. He winds up. He does not work, but he's a great display piece.
Mm-hmm.
I thought this one was really interesting. It's like
a little top hat.
Little top hat Santa with his boots and his little coat. Look at those shoulder pads. All new material, Japan.
Interesting.
Isn't that interesting?
Yeah, I've never seen one decorated like that.
Janine, I don't know if you grabbed... I know you grabbed a bunch of bunnies.
I think that's
bunnies.
The one I found.
I think there's a few that we have, so we're going to keep pulling some out. These are really cute. Probably from the 70s. Late 60s. For Easter, right?
Yep.
Almost didn't grab this, but I saw the side of the box, and I was like, oh boy. What's in here? And we opened him up.
Wow.
Tomato Santa.
It's a Nomus Santa.
I mean, that is so cool. I don't know if he works. We'll have to test him, but I couldn't not...
I know.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. When it's there and And it's in the box? How do you not? Janine just gave me a puzzled look.
Yeah, what is this?
This is like a Top Hat King Santa version. I've never seen him before.
Look, he has like diamond eyes.
And I know they made white versions of King Santa. We'll put in a picture of the original King Santa that we're referencing. But this is a different version for sure.
Wow.
He's missing whatever he would have held on to in that hole.
Mm-hmm.
But really cool.
That's so unique.
He's a bank.
Wow.
Janine, I haven't even looked at this.
Oh, wow.
I didn't even realize.
Wait, he's like not even in the camera.
He is a little really crunchy. Brittle.
He's a crunchy boy.
He's got a break in his face. He is a crunchy boy. But I mean, with a little scarf?
He is sweet.
Can you believe that?
Yeah, he's like Teletubby Santa.
Those blue eyes. He's in rough condition, but for somebody who likes the dolls and the pieces with that like vintage patina and wear on them, this would look really great in a display.
Cool.
Had to pick up this set of glamour lights. Mainly for the artwork. This is made by Noma. This is probably from the early 60s, mid 60s. It was originally 50 cents. You've got Artist Santa on here. And these are actually like flowers. Mm. Plastic flowers with lights. I was so surprised to find these. If you find these dear, they're a good find. But when you find them in pink and blue.
The one has jewels.
And green. Yeah, originally I think they came out.
No, the other one has them in the eye.
Oh. Guys, these go for silly prices on eBay.
Wow.
30 to 50. Because of the color.
Mm-hmm.
Only because of the color, which is crazy. I mean, these didn't come with the bows originally, so I'll take that off, but very hard to come by.
Can I see the one with the, the jewels? So if we can, this one kind of shines. See, look at that.
Yep.
The little jewel in the eye. How pretty.
It's so cool. And I mean, we could replace this one
absolutely.
Probably.
You could replace it.
So definitely keep an eye out for colored deer. These are made in Hong Kong. Or actually, no, Janine, I was wrong.
Yeah.
Japan. A bit older. Really fantastic find. Something only found in the wild maybe once before. Okay, I'm going into the bag now. Got a little elf here who needs some cleaning. Another little elf. He's really cute. I found a garland of mercury beads in these beautiful colors. Look at that.
There's the bag I've been looking for.
Here's Janine's bag that she picked up that we will pull out and she will show us what's inside. And she also found, sorry Janine, I mean extremely dirty. This was in the kitchen, but this is an older Samsung import, which is actually Relpo, same manufacturer. They probably changed names over the years. It's a little planter with a light.
So cool.
This is such a great find, Janine. This is like rare, hard to find Halloween ceramic.
So this little bag of goodies, I looked through and I had to take some things that were in it, including this beautiful big Christmas ornament. I mean, it's beautiful, this purple color. But look at this, Laura.
Okay.
I showed this to you very briefly in the house. Look at that.
This is a Bradford, I want to say, ornament, maybe? It's either, I think it's Bradford. Harder to find.
I think this is from the 40s.
Yes, I was going to say, older.
Yes.
An older ornament, for sure. It might even be celluloid. Yeah, that's probably celluloid. Actually, let me see. Oh, excuse me, Janine, just had to pull out my glow, the plastics issue.
Well, now you just put it on top of him.
It's in here. I know it's in here. This is a magazine called the Magazine of the Golden Glow of Christmas Past. It's a subscription. I'm not currently subscribed, but I did subscribe for their plastics issue. It just has a ton of information. I mean, look at that. And I know that that ornament is in here somewhere. So this was the closest example we could find. What could very well be, Janine, is that this is the original mold.
Mm-hmm.
And they used it a little bit later in time for an ornament.
Mm-hmm.
If you look at the other ornaments, though...
We need to find one of these.
Yeah, can we please? here are some of their unbreakable post-war Christmas decorations. You know, the Bradfords. I'd say it's probably from this era, probably very early 50s, if I had to guess. And it's a fantastic find.
Thank you.
So cool.
I had to pick up little plastic things like this.
Oh, he's cute.
Isn't he cute? He was definitely like a candy container that you can make into an ornament.
What an interesting snowman. I found two coloring books, Christmas coloring books, big Christmas coloring books. How exciting are these? These really excite me. I'm looking for a date. I don't know if we will find one, but these are probably early 70s, if I had to guess. Oh, somebody did a good job. I was really wrong. This is from 1958.
I was going to say, I think they're from the 50s, yeah. But I didn't want to.
Well, I don't know. I was thinking because they're so big and because they're in such good condition, I thought maybe they were a little bit newer. But they are both from 1958, wow. It looks like, or maybe 57. For the covers mainly, right? But mm-hmm. How amazing is that?
So cool. He's flocked, too. Mm-hmm. So, very cool.
So, after a quick break to sneeze multiple times, there he is.
Nutmeg Hole Towered Santa.
How cool.
Don't have him in the collection. He is a rare boy. He is harder to find than the salt and pepper shakers.
I'm just going to take stuff out of the box, Laura. Mm-hmm. So, feel free to pick them up and talk about them. But... you know, we have to unwrap some stuff.
Yeah, so. We do, because I don't even... this is one of the first boxes I grabbed out of the sale. The knee hugger was not in there, though. I must have found him somewhere else. And also the same is for this musical Santa in the original box. He does have a little break in his head over there, but hard to notice, really. He's fantastic. He plays Jingle Bells. Look at him. Oh, yeah, he's got some breakage. But, I mean, how do you just leave him there, you know? I don't think you can. Whole towered candle holders, which I almost put back because there is obviously considerable paint loss on the face there. But I mean, I don't know. They ended up in the box. Now these were actually, when I thought my GoPro was filming, the very first thing I grabbed. These were in the living room, just on like a table. These. There should be another one of this, Janine.
Yeah, I'll find it.
Okay. This, right here, the snowman with the little Christmas hat, is a Whole Tower 1958 candle holder set. Hard to come by, very collectible. For someone like me who collects vintage Christmas ceramics, these will have to stay in the collection. I'm just so surprised they were there.
We just made an exciting discovery.
Okay, so the feet we were talking about belongs to a Napco decanter from 1958. This is, now I've been on the lookout and collecting Christmas ceramics for about going on 5 years now, which I know is not that long, but I've done lots of research and I've never come across a decanter like this. Have you guys? He sits on top of these little feet, which is so cool, so different. He is in great shape. I was so surprised the condition he's in. And look at how he just stands up. He's pretty big. Now, I looked him up on eBay, and he's a rare one. He sells for a lot, but I thought that the cups were missing. But Janine just pulled these out.
We have them, Laura. You did find them.
The whole set is here. That is so amazing. I'm so excited. I really thought that these weren't, because I didn't see them when I went through that mm-hmm. bag really quickly at the sale. But yeah, the whole set is here, and that just makes me really happy.
Also, the other snowman.
Janine pulled out the other whole towered snowman. So they are a set, a little bit of paint loss, but nothing too bad. They definitely need a bath.
More Halloween?
Yeah, look, this is some of the first stuff I grabbed. I saw a Blinky.
Okay, let's take him out first.
Who is he? I don't even remember.
Look at him.
Oh, he's similar to the one in the box.
You pull him and he plays music?
Probably. Wow. Here's his brother right there. Amazing. Good condition.
That?
Another musical Santa. Plastic.
Or is that a light?
You want to try pulling that? I doubt it works.
I don't think you pull it. I think...
oh.
I don't know. Okay. I don't want
to
break it.
Okay. Very cool.
Uh-oh. Oh!
Oh my gosh, yes! These were in that tray that we showed with all the ceramics and the picture set, but they didn't have any bodies.
I don't think they had bodies.
Did they? Yeah, maybe not. They might have just been little ornaments. Oh, these are paper mache, probably made in Germany. Little Santa heads. Obviously, their noses have gone missing a bit, but How cool is that?
Very cool. Okay, and here.
And there he is.
Blinky!
Mr. Blinky!
Blinky!
Surprising that that was there since it's so much newer than everything else. This is
right.
80s?
Yeah. Cool.
Also found a Fenton fairy lamp, which is very exciting. Fairy lamps, for some reason, in our neck of the woods are harder to find. And then Janine spotted this really cute astronaut bank.
Isn't that cool?
Really fun. And we picked that up too. Really dirty. And wait, Janine didn't even talk about this. Santa decanter. Oh my goodness. So this is the decanter and his little hat top comes off. And then he's got these hooks for these tiny little Santa mugs to hang from.
Oh, that's so cool.
And it looks like this is complete too. I mean, that's incredible. That's so cool. I found him once before in a different variation, not as nice. That's a good find. Okay, guys, this is the last of it and we've got Santa. He's not looking that hot, just laying on top of the pile, but he was cute though. I mean, I know he's in really rough shape, but I thought he had the cutest little face. Maybe we can replace the beard. If you guys have any tips, this seems like a cotton ball material. So maybe we can work some magic on him. I don't know, but I just fell in love with that face. Janine found this box of greeting cards or birthday cards.
Yeah, and they're in there.
Want to take a look? Wow, look at that.
And they're like
pop-up.
Yeah, I'll hold them while I'm here.
Oh, cute. Wow, look at that. So there's a bunch of them in here. This owl one was really cool that we looked at before. Look at their eyes. So cool. We do. Happy birthday. Wow. So cool.
I was so excited to find this Rudolph because I've always wanted to find something like old Rudolph in the wild. There's a lot of people who collect all the different Rudolph stuff. And Rudolph is an old story and it has a lot of old products to go along with it. And this happens to be one of them. This is a children's tea set.
How cute.
So here is the sugar.
Look at the handles, how they are also Rudolph's.
And here is the teapot.
Wow.
Pours out of his little mouth. So obviously the red paint often chips off of old ceramics. So this bell would have been red. The nose would have been red. You have a little...
Oh my goodness. Is this the creamer?
A little creamer. You know, that one might not go with it.
Yeah, it doesn't look like it, right?
So that's here's the creamer. With yep. The tiny little deer head.
That's so cute.
It's so cute. There's no maker on it, but I think it's so cool. This is something that I personally, I'm not going to collect it, but I've always wanted to find it. So in the one of our future sales, at some point, this will be for sale.
And actually a good amount of this will be for sale because as much as we love vintage Christmas, Janine has told me many a times, the collection's getting too big. We can't keep it all, Laura. But honestly, we find such joy in passing along some of the things that we find. Mm-hmm. So
yeah, there'll be a percentage of this that will stay with us. For but, sure. Stuff like this, is so cool and cute. This little mouth will be passed on to you guys. And the sales will be mostly, I think, on Whatnot, no?
I think so. At least through the end of the year.
Yeah.
And also kudos to you, Janine, for finding those. They were buried in a big box of glass.
Yeah.
And I didn't see them. So.
I lifted a box and then I saw something brown and it was the little teapot, little face of Rudolph. So it was so exciting.
We found some more blow molds here. Janine, this is another rabbit. One of us found.
Yes, I think I found this one.
The purple one?
Yes.
Very cute. So we have a pair. And then somebody at the sale was like, hey, you guys are like grabbing a lot of, you know, the blow molds and stuff. Would you be interested in this one?
Yeah.
And we're like, yes, please.
We've never found this one. This is so cool. It's double-sided.
So amazing.
Little Santa head. I love this. This has been on my list of blow molds. So this was really nice that someone passed it over to us. Because, like, you don't have to. Like, that was really sweet. Like, she wasn't looking for the Christmas blow molds and stuff like that. She was looking for ornaments. Mm-hmm. So it was really nice that she handed this over to us.
And when we found ornaments, we handed them over to her. When I first walked into that room where I found the first tray, I did see a cookie jar Santa blow mold, but he did not have his hat.
Because of Janine's meticulous searching and looking, she found a hat to one.
Yes.
So we were able to complete one of the cookie jars, which is just so exciting.
He is so dirty, but he'll clean up very nicely.
Yeah, I wish we could have had the time to show you guys this all cleaned up, but that's going to take a while.
Yeah, follow us on Instagram at @shinybrightdoggo, and when we clean these up, we'll probably post like pictures on our story.
Mm-hmm. I'm really interested in this.
Oh my goodness.
When you pulled this out of a box.
So dirty. It's so...
What's that?
Don't worry about it. Little things I found. This was in the far, far, far corner of the bedroom room. Oh my goodness. And I was like, oh my gosh, is it in there?
No. Wait, what is this, Janine?
Oh, this is a Santa sleigh, and he holds candy.
Wow, look at that. Is this a Rosbro?
Ros and Company.
Ros and Company. There we go. Okay, so just wanted to let the people... Okay, so this is a plastic 1950s candy container box. Yes,
in gleaming plastic. So I haven't taken it out.
It's in there?
But when I peeked... Yes, it's in there. And when I peeked in, it still has the original candy.
Stop, can I look?
Which is pretty gross and disgusting.
But how cool!
This was kept in the box.
Can we take it out?
Yeah, let's
okay.
take it out.
Okay, we're having a little difficulty figuring out how to pull it out because the bottom is cardboard. There's a lot of gunk going on in there.
Yeah.
Do you think that's from the candy?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna clean the box off and stuff. I won't take it out just yet because I need to.
It's gonna take some work, I guess.
Yeah. But just beautiful. Look at that moon, has a face on it. So cool. So here's some of the stuff that I found after Laura found most everything.
Wow, I wonder if he works. Probably does.
Yeah.
It looks like brand new.
There's a good chance that he does. This mustard guy I thought was so interesting.
He's really cute.
Where is his spoon?
His spoon is in here. It's right there.
There he is. He's really cute. He's a little mustard guy.
He's giving me whole Howard vibes, but I don't believe he is.
Yeah, I don't think so either. He is marked.
We'll put up a comp if we find anything.
Whole Howard didn't really do stamps with mm-mm. numbers like that. They usually dated their pieces with the year and the stamp that usually said Whole Howard or would have the sticker. So having like the K2597 is more like you see that on like what?
Lefton, Napco,
other brands.
We'll put in a comp if we find anything though. He's really cute.
Yeah, he's cute, isn't he?
I dug around in some boxes for a while and came across a little corner with some Putz houses in them. Some of the doors are broken in, but the color is fantastic on these otherwise.
Yeah.
They're in good condition otherwise. They're not yellowed. And this one is really cool.
Reminds me of the thing that I found in Pennsylvania.
Yes.
Oh, that's beautiful.
A little Putz lantern.
That is beautiful. It's in wonderful shape.
Yeah.
Very clean. The mica is sparkling. That's beautiful, Laura.
Thank you. When we came across these guys, I was like so shocked. These are old candles.
I want to show the base.
The base is like a tin metal.
Oh, so pretty.
These are almost like a paper cardboard. And you've got your old Mazda bulbs on these. Look at the cords. See how they're wrapped like this?
Look how pretty those bases are. The detail are just beautiful.
Wrapped cords like this are a dead giveaway that you're dealing with lights from the 1950s, early 1960s. And look at these. These are so cool.
Wow.
Amazing. These are like, I love them. So we're going to plug them in and see if they work. I'd be surprised if they do, given how old they are.
Mm-hmm.
And they have these are the original bulbs for sure. So let's plug them in and see.
Okay, I'm filming. You're plugging them in. Wow. They both work. Be careful. Those are going to like set that on fire. But oh my goodness. How beautiful.
I'm so surprised they work. These are so old, guys. These are so fantastic. Super hard to come by. These are 50s.
I wish you could really see the color. They have a beautiful orange glow. But here... It's kind of being washed out, but it's so pretty. You know what's really cool?
What?
So the house had a lot of like older toys, some toys like tin, big tin toys, things that we don't pick up and stuff to resell. But I did see these. These are something that I've been on the lookout for. Too bad the top is cut off, but if you are an 80s kid, I'm sure you can identify these. These are from 1980.
85. I think they were called like Muscle Men or something. Yeah, Free Muscle Dude, whatever they're called. And I know they're like pretty collectible. I wish that it was like complete, because collectors, obviously, it would be a little more, it'd be worth a little more, right? Thank you. Collector would, if it's sealed like this, would prefer it to have the complete original packaging, not it cut in half. So I don't know, maybe someone would want to open it. I don't know, but these are collectible. So these are very, very cool. They're very brittle. They're made of plastic, and they are Princess Sculptured Christmas Decorations.
Wow, that's a name.
Originally 39 cents. And there's four of them, and they are these pretty bells.
They're three-dimensional, right? They pop out.
Yeah. Aren't those cool? I've never seen anything like them. I don't know when they're from. I'm thinking maybe 70s. Mm-hmm. They're very cool. I just thought they were, like, really cool.
For one of the last things that we found at that sale, I pulled out a box of Rosbros and Christmas plastics, but in that box was this incredible... Wow. 1970s Halloween flashlight. I mean, this is so hard to find. Pretty rare. It's a fun world. Made in Hong Kong. What a fun face. I don't know if it works. We haven't tried it out. But guys, let us know what you thought of this video. I know a lot of it was the haul. But believe me, when we went in there, it was just boxes filled with this stuff. And all I could do was take it. So there wasn't a ton of going through the stuff in the house. Really, what we saw for the first time was like during this haul. It was so exciting. We hope you guys enjoyed seeing everything. Maybe we'll go back on Saturday.
Yeah, maybe.
See if there's anything left. But we had a lot of fun, and we hope you did too. It's our pleasure to bring you along and unveil everything that we found in these boxes. Just decades of Christmas and holiday memories and treasures. Thanks for joining us, guys.
See you next time. Bye.